Hello, welcome to Sitter's Bakers. Today we're going to be making lemon meringue pie. This is a standard pie that should be in basically all bakeries that make pies. So, let's get into it. This lemon meringue pie recipe is a pre-baked pie recipe. So we're going to pre-bake our pie dough, get it in the oven, have it fully cooked, be done. Then we'll start working on our meringue and our lemon curd. You can use the regular lemon curd that I normally use for lemon squares and for the lemon cheesecake circles, but it doesn't pair properly. Because the lemon cheesecake squares or circles and the lemon squares have that rich, buttery cream cheese or shortbread, you need a more powerful lemon curd. Now with this one, it has that meringue as well. So if you go too sweet or too sour, you're gonna take away from the meringue. So this one is slightly adjusted to make sure that it makes a better lemon curd that complements everything. However, if you prefer the other lemon curd, you can just use that exact same recipe. Nothing's gonna change. You just gotta make sure that you use the correct amount and level it off nicely. But before all that, let's get this rolled out. So now that's fully rolled out, just put it onto our pie. Just like so. And just get it in nicely. Make sure you're lifting up so you're not damaging it while putting it in. And then we're gonna remember, because it's not a covered pie, you need to cut extra off so you have more space to make your crimp. So now that we have this, we're going to just fold over to make a nice crust around the whole thing. Now make sure that they're nice and tight, so it's basically one dough. Now one last thing before I put it in the oven, we need to egg wash and put the baking beans in. Remember, you don't need to put the egg wash down here. In fact, you don't really want to, because it's gonna make your baking beans stick, but you want to make sure you egg wash everywhere that's going to be seen. However, don't be silly. If you have a lot of egg wash down here, don't just leave it there, because you're just going to make eggs, scrambled eggs. There we are. Now we're going to just put our parchment paper in. And put our baking beans and rice. Make sure you fill into the corners so that all of this bakes properly. Now we're gonna put it in the oven for 45 to 50 minutes. We're just gonna make sure that it's fully cooked and there's no raw spots. So to do that, just open this up. Look in there. If it's raw on the bottom, then keep going till it's not raw in the end. So let's get baking. While you're waiting for your pie to finish cooking, separate your eggs, get your yolks on one side and your egg whites on the other, and then just set up everything. So you know you're going to need your sugar, your salt, your lemon juice, all in one area. Your cornstarch. So we'll mix this up and then start putting this on a bain-marie once the pie is out, because we do want the pie to cool down fully before we put the filling in. I have my salt, sugar, and cream of tartar ready to go for my egg whites. Remember,
Egg whites are different from cream. Cream you want as cold as possible to get as much volume as possible. But with egg whites, the warmer they are, the more they'll whip properly. So keep that in mind when you're doing all this. If you take these out and leave them on the counter, you'll actually get a better product because they'll have gone to room temperature instead of being cold in the fridge. So now that I have everything ready, I have my butter weighed out as well. We're just gonna wait for the pie to come out and then we'll start putting both of these on bain-marie's. Here it is, just came out. Nice and cooked down at the bottom. We're gonna just let this cool down with the rice and baking beans in. And then we're gonna get started on our filling and meringue. So now we're gonna whip our sugar, cream of tartar, and salt with our eggs. We're just gonna mix this up until it becomes body temperature. And what that does is it allows it to be whipped up and hold its shape and not slowly turn back into egg whites. If you just put sugar and egg whites together, start whipping it up at room temperature or cold, what will end up happening is it'll get to the nice hard peaks, but slowly over time it will start to liquefy again. This way, it doesn't liquefy again, and it works out even better. It also gives it a nice shine to it. So we're just going to stir this up until it becomes room temperature. And what you do, on the back of your finger, touch it. If you feels like nothing, that means it's to your body temperature. While this is heating up, I'm going to do the same for our filling mixture. So we're just gonna mix this up until it's nice and thick and the sugar is melted. Once the sugar is melted, we're gonna temper it back into our yolks, and then we'll pour all this back in here, get it to a simmer so that all the cornstarch is cooked out, and then we'll put that into our pie. The reason why we're using bain-marie's, which is just boiling water in a pot, is because it doesn't put your eggs directly on the heat and makes sure that your eggs don't turn into just scrambled eggs. And same with over here, if you put this directly on the heat, your cornstarch will thicken up and make gelatinous cubes, and it won't really look pretty, and you'll have to strain those out, then you'll need more cornstarch. It's just a mess. So make sure that you're using a bain-marie so that it's a lot easier for yourself. However, if you're doing a huge batch, it will take forever to use a bain-marie, but I still recommend using the bain-marie to get it started, because once it gets started, it won't mess up, and then you can put it on direct heat, and as long as you're paying attention to it, everything should be fine. With the lemon curd only, the egg whites, always bain-marie. No matter how much you're making, always bain-marie, or you're just gonna make egg white omelet. I've just felt my egg whites. They're just warm to the touch on the back of my hand. So I'm gonna quickly just put a tiny bit of vanilla. Mix that up. And then put it on the machine to whip up until hard peaks, okay? Once your mixture has gone thick, take it off the heat. Mix just a tiny bit in with your yolks. I need a little bit more. That will temper it, then pour it all back in. Mix it up nicely, make sure that none of it cooks. And then we're gonna put it directly on the heat. We wanna make sure that we cook out that cornstarch flavor, because if we don't, it's gonna have a nice, or like a weird, filmy taste to it, and it's not so good. So just keep mixing it, and make sure you don't run away from this, or it will burn. Once it starts to thicken up like this, and it starts to boil, that's when you know it's perfect. It's getting to that stage where the cornstarch is cooking out, and it's going to be perfectly thick for when you strain it into your pie shell. We are going to be straining this because all
curds need to be strained. Every egg yolk has that tiny bit of connecting tissue to the whites, and because of that, if you don't strain it, you're gonna get these weird, they look like white threads, and people will start to think that you're putting white threads in their food, so you gotta make sure that you get rid of them by straining. Once you're done straining, scrape all the bottom off of your strainer, then you'll have a nice curd, pour it in, and then you need to cover it with plastic wrap, touching the curd, or you'll get a skin on it and it's not gonna be good. Make sure you shake it a bit to level it out. Put the plastic wrap on, put it in the fridge, let it cool down fully before putting the meringue on.
Now that these have cooled down, this is fully cooled, it's not gonna move anywhere, and we've whipped our eggs. There's two ways you can do this. You can either put this on and then mold it with this, or you can pipe it on. I'm going to just mold it on because that's generally the easiest way to do it. So you can cover everything easily. Make sure you cover all the custard or you'll have sweat marks, which is just liquid in between your meringue and your curd. Once you're happy with how much you've covered, you can now make this as tall as you want. And there's two ways you can brown this. You can use a torch, or what I'm going to do is put this back in the oven. I'm gonna have my oven set at 450, as hot as I can make it go. And all I'm going to do is put it in till it's browns. So that could be just a few minutes. So if you prefer just a quick molded way, it's the easiest way, or if you prefer piping to get different designs, it's all up to you. I like to have this design, but play around with it. It's a lot of fun, but we're gonna quickly put this in the oven for a few minutes until this starts to turn brown. As soon as it turns brown, we take it out immediately. Here it is after 2 minutes. It's nice and hard crust, nice and dark colored, looking good. I'm just gonna set this up to taste test and take some pictures, and then I can give you my feedback. So let's give this a nice taste test. There looks like to be a lot of meringue, but just keep in mind, this lemon curd is very powerful, so you want to be having a lot of meringue mixed with your curd. It's a lot more mellow taste. It's not too overpowering. The meringue smooths it out, and with that tiny bit of crust, you get that richness as well. Very tasty. It's a little sweet. I might reduce the sugar in the curd just a bit more, just to make sure that it's not the only flavor you get in. It starts to stick to the roof of your mouth, which makes it so that the only taste you're getting is sweetness. So if I reduce by probably 50 grams sugar, this recipe will be perfect. So if you've liked this video, please like and subscribe. You can follow me on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. I even have my own website. Thank you, and have a nice day.